Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I want to thank to the organizing committee for this opportunity. My name is Oscar Rodriguez Dima, and I'm from Mexico City. I'm going to present my doctoral work. Tenia solium is a cestod parasite. It produces teniosis by consumption of cysticercy by humans, and cysticercosis by consumption of eggs in humans and swines. The most important affection is when a cysticercy is located in the neural, in the central neural system. This is called neurocysticercosis. Neurocysticercosis is a health problem in most of the developing countries. It's the most important parasitic disease of the central nervous system and the first cause of late epilepsy. In Mexico, it's still prevalent. It represents 2.5% of the total patients of the National Institute of Neurology and Neurosurgery. In Tenia solium, the transcription machinery is unknown. For that reason, we decided to start studying the RNA Pol2 transcription machinery. Pol2 is important for the protein coding genes. For the start of transcription by Pol2, is necessary the binding of several transcription factors in a region known as core promoter. In this slide, we can see a representative elements of the core promoter. Representative elements of the core promoter, such as TF2B recognizing element, Tata box initiator, and downstream promoter element. In Tenia solium, only a few sequences of core promoters has been published. In here, we can see representative core promoters of genes like actin-5, typical 2-cis peroxyreduxine, and superoxide dismutase. We can see these elements present and, okay. Tata box is the binding site for TBP. It's localized between -31 to -26 base pairs relative to transcription start site. TBP is this protein you can see here. TBP can be divided into important domains. The first is the carboxyterminal domain, who is in charge of DNA binding. And the amino terminal domain, who is in charge of binding of several other transcription factors. In Tenia solium, we can isolate the cDNA encoding TSTBP1, deduct its amino acid sequence, and compare it to other TBP1s from the host, such as Suse scrofa, the swine or the pig, and Homo sapiens, and two related organisms such as Echinococcus granulosus and Echinococcus multilocularis. We can see here the classical amino terminal domain, who is not conserved between Tenia solium and Homo sapiens and Suse scrofa. But if you can see here the carboxyterminal domain, who is high conserved between all species. This is important because in the carboxyterminal domain, we can see all the amino acids important for the interaction with DNA and other transcription factors. With the deduced amino acid sequence, we construct a homology model using the TBP1 crystallographic data from human TBP1. We can see the model constructed and corresponds to the TBP superfamily structure. When we perform a superposition of several structures, we can see a conservation of the structure and the possibility of interaction with TF2B, TF2A, and DNA, of course. We localize the amino acid important for the DNA interaction and the positive patches generated by them, who possibilitates the interaction with the phosphates of the backbone, of the DNA backbone. We also identify the native TSTBP1 by Western blot in nuclear extracts using two antibodies. The first against amino terminal domain, the second against amino terminal domain. We use these antibodies for the recognizing of TBP in slides of cysticercy. We can see the colocalization here of this is the DNA marker, this is TBP, this is histone, and this is the merge of the signals. We can see the colocalization of TBP, histone, and DNA. Then, in order to know if TSTBP1 can bind to TATAVOX, we perform electrophoretical mobility shift aside using four probes. The first one is from Actin-5, the second is for 2-cis peroxyredoxane, a consensus TATAVOX, and a mutated consensus TATAVOX. In both experiments, we can observe a shifted band in lane 2, this and this, the decrease of the intensity in the shifted band due to homologous competition, then a super-shifted band when we use antibody and form a super-shifted complex, and then a positive control, the negative control, and the heterologous competition. The conclusion of this experiment is that the TATAVOX of Actin-5 is stronger than the TATAVOX of 2-cis peroxyredoxine. Okay, we possess two antibodies. We need to know if one of these antibodies is capable to inhibit the interaction between TSTBP1 and TATAVOX. We performed several experiments, and it's represented in this EMSA, scale. We can see that when we use carboxyterminal domain antibody, we can inhibit the interaction between TSTBP1 and DNA. And this is the normal interaction between the carboxyterminal domain. Those are negative and positive controls. This is our first step to try to inhibit this interaction. Then, we analyze the genomic sequence of TSTBP1. We characterize the proximal promoter and see different elements. First of all, we detect two domains, two AT-rich regions, the first of minus 97 and the second at minus 69. We can see in this EMSA that those TATAVOX can bind to TSTBP1. We conclude that this is a TATA-less gene. Then we detect an element here that is close to downstream promoter element. We perform EMSA and we obtain a shifted band and a super shifted band when we use TBP associated factor Cs, who is a related protein of TBP. We identify TS TAF6 by confocal microscopy and obtain his amino acid sequence. We perform a homology model and compare to the Antonospora locustei crystallographic data. And finally, we collect all the information relative to co-promoters in Tenida family. We can see a conservation. We form two groups, two different groups. The first group possess TATAVOX, and the second group is a TATA-less group. We can see a conservation of the TATAVOX between this sequence and the DPA motif, the downstream promoter element motif, in this species. But we can see a high variability when the initiator sequence is compared. The aim of this project was, in first place, try to determine if we can inhibit this protein. And if we can inhibit this protein, if this leads to the death of the organism. We can observe that we can inhibit this process, but we have not determined if this leads to death. Okay, this is all of my part. Thank you for your attention and some question.
Okay, has anybody got any questions?
Yes.
I didn't get whether you use the same antibody for super shift and for block.
Again, please.
Was it the same antibody that you use for super shift? And it was one EMSA?
In this?
Yes, in this one.
Okay, we have two antibodies.
Three the and four, right? So the lane 3 and 4, that is the question.
Yes. We have two antibodies. The first of the antibody is recognized, it's against aminoterminal domain. And the second, it's against carboxyterminal domain. Okay, when we use the aminoterminal domain, we can see a super shift band here. Okay? This experiment is first when we incubate DNA with nuclear extract. And then we change the incubation. First, we incubate the extracts, the nuclear extracts, with the antibody. Okay? And this is for the carboxy-terminal domain. In the first experiment, we don't see an inhibition, but in the second one, we see an inhibition.
Okay, any further questions? Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.